What is up, gang? This is the Axiom Featurette channel. I'm Chris, and I have a video for you. And this is going to be the answer portion to 2 weeks ago, I did a Q&A to celebrate 1,000 subscribers, which is totally awesome. Felt like I was never going to get there, but you know, finally posting regular videos for the first time in years. So I really appreciate all you in subscribing. So, there was a bunch of questions. I was shocked how many questions I had. So thank you. That was like super fun thinking about some of these questions. I had to think about for a long time because they were really, really good. So I very much so appreciate all of the questions that Inns ask. I pulled some selections off of the old abandoned movie rack to have a little visual aid to help us along. So let's just dive on into these questions. Again, thanks to everybody that made this possible by asking stuff. So here we go. Damian Beatty asked, first, did my family get me into smaller movies or did I come upon them myself? The smaller movies was basically like friends and stuff, like outer influence. It wasn't my family. My stepdad got me into like Star Trek from watching like the original series. And my aunt was a big influence on the type of movies that I watched because she was really into like horror and sci-fi. So that was like my first love. She was really, really into the Alien movies. So those were actually some of the first movies that I saw, like Alien and Tremors, Aliens. So I watched those a bit too young, probably shouldn't have been seeing them as young as I did. But she was also really into like Jaws and stuff, E.T., like a bunch of like stuff like that. So the bigger movies. So I wasn't really watching like the smaller films back then. Not until I met some friends and stuff, like after high school. It wasn't really until I got into like this group of like old friends that I had that, you know, they introduced me to like Full Moon and stuff like that. And through like Netflix, we would just, you know, we had the old mail-in discs and we would get like, I remember watching Ginger Dead Man and just stuff like that. So it was really, really cool. But it was friends that got me into that type of stuff. The next question was, if I could pick 5 VHS, 5 DVDs, and 5 Blu-rays to watch on an island and never watch anything else ever again, what would they be? And they can't be the same movie. So this was like super difficult, but it was very fun. So first of all, VHS. And these are in no particular order, but I just looked at and we have a lot of tapes that are put away, so this is just from like probably a small portion of our collection that we still have out, but there were still some good ones that we left out. So one of the first tapes that I ever watched was Meet Me in St. Louis with Judy Garland. My grandma used to watch this all the time with me. This and Cleopatra, I very vibrantly remember watching together. So Meet Me in St. Louis is a must. One of my favorite musicals ever. And next up, 10 to Midnight with Charles Bronson. This is a fantastic movie, one of my favorites of his. Next up, Blue City with Judd Nelson and Ally Sheedy. This does have a Blu-ray release, but I don't own it. And it's fantastic. It's seriously, I saw this on this tape for like the first time like years ago. And I was just like, this movie is amazing. I loved it. Very great movie. Waterworld with Kevin Costner. One of my favorite dystopian films. Now that I say that, I'm like, Mad Max is one of my favorite dystopian films, probably The Road Warrior. Looking at this pile, I don't have Mad Max in there, so I don't know, but I guess I would be stuck watching Waterworld for all eternity. And then Scanners, because I was like, it's a great movie, and I saw it. So, I don't know, just like this. So that 5, you know, I would be, it's a pretty solid 5 VHS pick, I think. So onto the DVDs, and this is where it gets funky because I got some wacky stuff in here, but my first one is Wrist Cutters, and I absolutely love this movie. It's one of my favorites of all time, and it's a black comedy. If you have not seen it, it's like, it's a love story, but it's weird. So this is what introduced me to Patrick Fugit, and I love him, so very much adore this movie. American Beauty, one of the first DVDs that I ever bought. I just think it's a fantastic film, so I could definitely watch that forever. Repo the Genetic Opera, again, one of my all-time favorites. Very underappreciated, and it makes me cry every time I watch it, so probably the only person that can say that. And then we have The Chum Scrubber with my boy Jamie Bell. This is like never talked about, and I absolutely love this movie. It's about it says what Meat Generation RX. So it's kind of like this story about these teens that are kind of like left to their own devices and forgotten about because everyone is so wrapped up in their own life. All the adults in their lives are like wrapped up in their selves, so they're just like trying to cope with life by themselves. And it's a very, like, the feel to it is very strange, but I absolutely adore this movie. It's amazing. And then finally, Pontypool, Shut Up or Die. My favorite zombie movie, I think, of all time. It's a Canadian film. We have Stephen McCaddy plays Grant Massey, who is absolutely amazing. Takes place in a radio station. If you have not seen this, I very highly suggest it. It is amazing. And then my five Blu-ray picks, Napoleon Dynamite, because why not? It's hilarious. One of my favorite comedies. I love it. Death Wish with Mr. Charles Bronson, because it's fantastic. One of the best revenge films of all time. American Psycho, because again, it's one of my all-time favorites. Absolutely love this story. Tenebrae, because it was my intro to Giallo, and it's probably still my favorite. I think that is perfect. And then finally, Friday the 13th, Part 6. So that's my, 15 films that I would choose. So let me know what you think about that. And then his last question is, what is my favorite mainstream movie that might surprise people? And this was such a difficult question for me. I was looking through my shelves and I'm like, none of this stuff's very mainstream. I don't watch a lot of like mainstream, like, blockbuster movies a lot. So I'm pretty out of touch when it comes to that stuff. But last January, I did watch a bunch of Jake Gyllenhaal flicks, and he does some really big, mainstream movies. So I was like, well, it's probably gonna be one of these. So it came down to Prisoners, which was fantastic. And then this one, which I picked, which is Brokeback Mountain. And this came out a while ago, and all I knew about it was like, oh, gay cowboys, like, whatever. I just knew what pop culture told me. Like, oh, I wish I could quit you. That's all I knew. So I started watching it, and I was like, this is phenomenal. Like, why did this become like a joke, basically? It became a joke of a movie. But it's actually, I was just talking to Lewis Witcher because he just watched Prisoners, and he's like, Jake Gyllenhaal never has emotion in his movies. Well, in this one, he absolutely does. He is phenomenal. Heath Ledger is phenomenal. This is just like a fantastic movie. So, it's very like slow, but it's not boring. It's the cinematography is beautiful. The story is just like, it's very gripping. And if you have not seen this, like, I don't know what you're doing, because I feel like it's a masterpiece. So I feel like that would shock people that I like this, but I love it. The next question comes from Greg Garwood, and he says, what is one of my favorite things about Pennsylvania? My favorite thing about Pennsylvania, and I mean, it's like a weird place, and it's not like the best. Pennsylvania is kind of two cities divided by the Amish, is like what people say. Two cities that hate each other divided by the Amish, but it's kind of true. But really, it's just a bunch of trees. Like, Pennsylvania means Penn's Woods. So, William Penn, what we learned in fourth grade Pennsylvania history was that England gifted the land to William Penn, and that's why it's named after him. What I like about it is the scenery. I love our trees. I love our rolling hills, like the top of Appalachia. So I love the landscape of Pennsylvania, and our state parks are beautiful. I used to go hiking a bunch, and I can just get lost in the state parks for hours. So that is definitely my favorite thing about PA. PA is weird though. I, grew up in the Rust Belt, so it's just home to me. Rust Belt is like a very weird area, very decrepit, but it is what it is. Greg's second question was, when walking into the woods at 2 a.m., what's my Bigfoot call sound like? And I don't want to be calling Bigfoot at 2 a.m. in the woods. That's the opposite of what I want to be doing. But if I were trying to interact with Squatch, I'd probably go, like a kitty cat. I'm sure he'd hear it and he'd come running. Or I'd just like snap into a Slim Jim. I think that works too. I'm not sure. Laren McMullen asks, will Lewis Witcher and I ever do another live stream? And I would like to. The problem is we can't really plan it out in advance because our toddler has like a very weird sleep schedule. So it's kind of hard to plan that stuff, but I would love to do another one. I now have a microphone, so I think that our audio will be, much improved. He also asks, what will 1,000 subscribers mean for monetization of the channel? This like ticks me off because before I had 1,000 subscribers, and also like I think the other criteria for having for allowing monetization is that you have to have 400 an average of 400 views or 400 like viewed hours per month or something, and I don't have that. And even if I did, like I'm not interested in making like money off of this channel. That was not ever the point of it, trust me. So, I mean, it would be like cool, but I just hate ads on videos and I don't want ads on my videos. But what ticks me off is that I turn off, like, I went into all the settings and I looked up so much stuff about this, about turning off ads on my channel, and I have it selected, and YouTube started adding advertisements to my channel, and I don't know how to fix it. I feel like I don't understand. I feel like they're on some videos and not on others, but it really, really ticks me off that I had those settings selected and they just like, they're like, oh, psych, we're gonna add, advertisements to your videos anyway. So, I mean, I guess if I were able to monetize, I should because they're just gonna keep adding ads anyway, whether I want them to or not. Like, it's pretty messed up, but, yeah, I don't know. You're never gonna catch me adding like a Patreon or anything. I'm lucky enough to get some screeners from some companies, and that is like, phenomenal to me. So that's amazing. But then his next question is, would I review Escape from New York? He said that, he knows it's not really my review style, but I would totally do it. I've actually never seen that movie. Even though like I love, like Big Trouble in Little China and stuff. So I mean, I guess it would be kind of cool to hear somebody that's never seen it before offer their opinion on it. So yeah, I would consider it. I just need to watch it first. And then finally, if I were to trade lives with a fictional character for a day, who would it be? And every time I thought about this, I was like, well, I don't want it to be somebody from a horror movie. I just keep coming back to like The Great Gatsby because he lives this like, fantastical life. So probably The Great Gatsby. The next question comes from, hey, isn't that Devon Graham? I think he's cute. He asks, what is my favorite boutique label and why? And I'm gonna say Arrow because I first of all, I like the like their catalog that they put out. They put out a lot of Gialli, a lot of like weird slashers and stuff. Like Asian movies. They put out a very mixed bag of stuff that I really appreciate. And then they have like the really sick reversible artwork, and the first pressing comes with the booklet, which is very nice. But I love their special features, like all of the commentaries. They get some, they do their own like, special features. So they have like new content. I love it. So, and I know like other labels do that too. But I'm just more interested in what Arrow's putting out. I definitely have more Arrows than like Criterion or something. So, yeah, I just am way more into their content. Then Physical Media Man, he look up him and give him a sub to Physical Media Man. He asks, what is something that I had in my collection that I got rid of and I really wish that I still had? And I don't really get rid of things that I am like attached to. But, I've lost along the way. One that is kind of easy to find still that I really need to get is Dr. Horrible Sing-Along Blog. I don't own that and I really need to buy it again. But the big thing that comes to mind is the Home Movies, like the big case that came with like the little director thing and had like a bag. I still have the tote bag for it, but I don't have the full complete series of home movies. It was like a animated show on Adult Swim back in the day. Brendan Small and stuff like that. It was really, really funny, but don't have it, and now it's like, super out of print and goes for a lot. So I'll never see that again. Wish I still had it. Aaron 303 asks, what are my favorite labels putting out upgraded releases? That would be Kino Lorber, because they're putting out like Blu-rays of all these wacky off the wall, like made for TV movies. So just based on like the weird stuff that you wouldn't ever expect to see coming to Blu-ray, we're now seeing because of Kino Lorber. I think that's amazing. And my favorite release of 2021, and that's gonna be Severin's release of Blood for Dracula. I love this movie, and I just showed it off recently, but seriously, this is my 2021 pick because it is absolutely beautiful. So, just take a minute to admire that. Uh-oh. Good thing she's centering herself. But yeah, this is amazing, and I was so excited for that. The next question comes from Mr. Dan and Horror. Make sure to check out his channel too, Mr. Dan and Horror. Have you been to Indiana, PA, and seen the Jimmy Stewart statue? And I have not. I did not even know that there was a Jimmy Stewart statue. I live in the Pittsburgh area, so Indiana is like very close. So the next time I'm headed in that direction, I will make a pit stop because that is super cool. I just watched, I say just watched, it was like 2 years ago probably, Rear Window. So I need to actually, I don't think I own that, I need to buy it and bring it there so I can, put it next to the statue and be a nerd. And then he asks, would I be interested in joining other horror tubers for live stream discussions? And that is awesome. Thank you for asking. I don't think that it's feasible in my life because of my 2-year-old, but I would definitely be interested in doing that in the future. Rune Mesa, my dude Kelly, says he had a bunch and they're all awesome, so thank you for that. He first asked, do I or did I play a musical instrument? And I always wanted to, but my mom was like, oh, I don't have money for that. So I had like a Casio keyboard when I was a kid and I was terrible at it. So whenever I got to be in like high school and college, I got a drum set and I would like mess around on that, but I never really did anything. So the answer is no. I attempted to, but very poorly. Do I like my name first, last, or both? My first name is Christine, and I do not like the name Christine. I think that it sounds very like uppity. So I go by Chris because I just don't like the name Christine. And it's the name of a car. So I don't like that movie because I don't like my name. So I like the name Chris though. Like it's pretty chill. My name's Chris, I don't like the name Christine. My last name I never really like cared for until recently. So as an adult I like it, but whenever I was growing up it was like really hard to like say. Like people never understood me even though it's like super common. The worst anthology movie I've seen. I've seen a lot of anthology movies and a lot of them aren't good. Like probably like ABCs of Death or something. I didn't like a lot of the little shorts in that. But I also really don't care that much for Creepshow, which is like a hot take. I wouldn't say that it's like horrible, but it wasn't for me. I know a lot of people are like way into it. I just feel like there's better horror anthologies, but favorite after closing credit scene from a movie. I really like the first one. Whenever I think about that, the first one I think about is the Evil Dead remake. So I don't know that it's necessarily my favorite, but it's the first thing that comes to mind, and it's very it like sticks out in my head, so that's cool. Who would win in a battle, the Thing or the Blob? I've never actually seen The Thing, so any either of them. So I'm gonna say the Blob, even though it's probably not true. The Blob's kind of lame. Like it was filmed in like Pennsylvania, so it's like you should be have some pride, but it was out near Philly, so it's not really like my Pennsylvania. I don't know. Like the Blob's kind of lame. I don't know, but I've never seen The Thing, so I can't really compare it. Yeah, I'm gonna catch some heat for that answer. Do I prefer to sit or recline when watching a movie? I don't actually have a recliner. I just have like a huge couch. So, I usually just sit, but with my feet elevated, but not in like a reclining position. So, I don't really like to lay down when I watch movies either, because I will probably fall asleep. My least favorite genre, definitely romance, maybe like war movies. I'm not really into war movies so much. There's a couple romance and a couple war movies that I like, but overall, I just stay away from those genres. Even like romantic comedies, I'm not a huge fan of. It has to be like really funny. I don't know, I'm just not into them. So you won't see a lot of those in our collection. The scariest or funniest nightmare I've had. I always had this nightmare where, I mean, aside from like nightmares where I'm at work, those always suck. I always had this nightmare about like an amusement park with penguins and then like falling off a cliff. I don't really know. It was just like, and when I say amusement park with penguins, like it was just a penguin themed, like everything was just penguins everywhere. And I don't really understand that. But then I fell off of a cliff. So, and I don't know what happens after that, but it was just like, what does that mean? What is going on here? Name some movies I've read the novel of. I like, and I don't know if this is all the ones that I have, but I really like reading novels of, movies that I've seen. So, first up, a couple Chuck Palahniuk books, Fight Club, which I obviously, if you've seen some of my other videos, I have about 16 different copies of Fight Club, the movie. And I think that I like the movie better than the book, and that's one of those rare situations where I can say that. I do like Chuck Palahniuk. I haven't read his books in forever, but this is a good book. It's just I feel like the movie did a lot better job. The book Choke. Do I have that movie? So there's, I don't know if you ever even heard of this movie, but who's in this? Sam Rockwell, Angelica Huston. I saw Choke because I knew that it was the same guy that did Fight Club, and then I read the book Choke afterwards, and they're both like, they're good if you want to watch something weird, you know? And then A Clockwork Orange, which I absolutely 100% loved this book. It's a short read, but it's a phenomenal, phenomenal book. And I so wanted to like the movie. But I hated it. It was so boring to me. I cannot stand Stanley Kubrick. I cannot. I find him like pretentious. I don't like it. Really don't like the movie, but I love, love, love the book. And then Rosemary's Baby, which I read this before watching the movie. I do have the Criterion somewhere up there, but I loved this book. It took me like a day to read it. I just was like so hooked on this book that I could not put it down. And as soon as I was done with it, like I had to go watch the movie. And I was glad that I did because I feel like watching Rosemary's Baby, you would miss a lot, or there's like a lot of like, leaps they have to make that the book bridges, obviously, because a book's gonna go into a lot more detail, but it's like there's so many fantastic elements to this book that I feel like they had to cram into this movie. So I would highly suggest reading this before watching it if possible. It's really, really good. And then I recently read American Psycho. I have watched American Psycho hundreds of times. Loved it, but the book, they're both good. They just have like different elements to them. If you're a fan of the movie, you have to read this because it's basically written the same, like it's written in a way that you can picture what's going on in the movie. And it's kind of like extra scenes. So it's like it's almost like extra scenes to the movie in this book. Like you can picture it in your head. So that's really cool. I will definitely be reading this again. Phenomenal. One of my favorite movie books that I've read. And then, which brings me to Let Me In, which I've owned this for years, and I was trying to hold off on watching Let Me In until I read the book, and I'm glad that I did. The book, it's so weird because I watched Let Me In and Let the Right One In And I read all of the comic books that there's like four, it's like a mini comic series. But so I read all the comic books and I read this. And it's so interesting because every story tells the story like a little bit differently. So if you compile them all together, you have this like, you know, like megaverse type thing going on. If you have not seen Let Me In or Let the Right One In, it is basically like a preteen vampire story. They're Hammer Films production, so that's interesting, but it's so unique. It's basically like, since they're kids, it like gives the vampire like almost a innocent type feel. I love it. I think that it's so cool and it's very haunting. It takes place in the cold, so very neat. You should probably check it out. The next question is my favorite story from the movie anthology Nightmares, which I don't think I've seen, so I can't really answer that. I guess I should. Coolest or most disappointing celebs that I've met? My answers all come from the same encounter. So the coolest celebrities were, and I went to this like Wizard World Comic Con years ago because all five captains from Star Trek were going to be there. And it was super cool. And I had just finished watching DS9, so I really wanted to go see Avery Brooks. And so I got to meet Patrick Stewart, who I love. The Next Generation was like my first love with Star Trek. You know, I had first watched the original series. Didn't really, like, it was whatever, it was fun, but it wasn't like as good as The Next Generation. So I loved that, wanted to see them. I met Patrick Stewart, and I remember, like, there was nobody in line to talk to them. Whenever I got up to talk to Patrick Stewart, someone had just handed him a coffee and he was like, "Oh, finally, I've been waiting for this for 3 hours." And he took a sip, like, "Oh, finally, my coffee." And I was like, "Well, was it at least worth the wait?" And he's like, "Yeah, it's actually not half bad. It's pretty good." And I was like, "It's pretty awesome just talking to Patrick Stewart about his coffee." And then I went over to the next table and saw Avery Brooks, who played Captain Sisko. Oh my God. I was trying to play it cool, but then Avery Brooks just like totally one-upped me because I was like, "Oh, how's your weekend going?" And he's like, "Well, good now that you're here." And I was like, "Oh, Avery Brooks, stop. Oh, Captain, my Captain." I was just like, gotta calm down. So, he's amazing. He is so, so cool. The worst celebrity I ever met was a couple tables over at William Shatner. He's just such a douchebag. I never liked him. He's a terrible actor. He's just like so pompous for no reason. And the only reason I feel like people like him is because he's a joke. So I would not have even have won over there if the person that I was with didn't want to get his autograph. But basically, like, he was like, "Well, you know, you get an autograph and I'll get an autograph and we can go up together." And I'm like, "Okay." And he didn't say one word to us. He just like looked down. You just like put your thing there and he signs it. And like, dude, you're not big enough to be doing that. Come on. Like, you're William Shatner. Like, I was like, what a douche. So, that's my answer to that. What movie character would I like as a friend? My answer to that is Donnie Darko. Not only because Jake Gyllenhaal is a super hottie, but because I feel like Donnie Darko is just a strange kid, and he would be like a really like weird person to hang out with around the neighborhood, you know? So that would be my friend. What weapon or tool from a movie would you like to have? I couldn't think of any weapons or anything, but the thing that I first thought of was the little clamshell like e-reader that they use in It Follows, which was totally cool. It's literally like a clamshell. It looks like a compact or like a Polly Pocket or something, but she's just like, you know, just scrolling through, like looking at this little clamshell, and I'm like, that is so cute. Like, I want one of those. And that's what I like about It Follows, is that it has like it creates like this weird technology, and like it doesn't really have technology in the movie, so it has like an anytime feel to it. So I really enjoyed that about it, but really want that little clamshell. The thing was so cool. What film should be remade? Okay, here's one. I would love to see I would love to see a remake of The Clockwork Orange because I don't think there's any reason it needs to be that long. I don't think that there's any reason it needs to be like as boring as it is. I think that it could be exciting and fast paced, and I think that it deserves to be that. So I'd love to see a remake of that. And then finally, do I have a region-free player? Yes, I do. We don't keep it hooked up 24/7 at the moment, but we intend to. Like right now, we just pretty much switch it out if we need to watch something that's not Region A. The next questions come from Nightwatch Zone, so go subscribe to their channel on here. What is my favorite video I've done? I think that is probably my first Kino Lorber highlights video where I'm just like going through like pulling stuff randomly off the shelf because I don't know, it's just pretty spur of the moment. And then the thing that I enjoy the least about YouTube, the ads. I think that is ridiculous and I don't like the algorithm. I don't like how certain channels are constantly fed to people. So it's like you're always getting the same suggestions over and over again. I think that that's really BS. And then the thing I enjoy least about being a YouTuber, which is gonna be like editing my videos, editing and uploading and just managing the files themselves. I don't know, that kind of sucks. I hate that. Andres Salguero says, top three favorite films I've seen this year for the first time. Wow, I saw so many good movies this year, so this was kind of difficult, but I'm gonna go with, in no particular order, Enemy with Jake Gyllenhaal because I went through a Gyllenhaal January. So, Enemy was probably my favorite movie with him. Very surreal. I just very thoroughly enjoyed it. And then I saw The Devil, which I recently watched, and it was not at all what I was expecting. It was very violent, but it also had like a mystery element to it. So, very, very enjoyable. If you have not seen this, you really need to. And then finally, I'm gonna say Battle Royale, which My Blood Oozy Suicide 666 recommended that I watch. And so I watched it like streaming somewhere, but oh my gosh, it was amazing. And then like the story is very similar to like Squid Game, how it's like a basically like a game, like a kid's game or whatever. Turned brutal, so Battle Royale was fantastic. I don't know how I didn't see it like years and years ago, but really enjoyed that. So all three of those are phenomenal. Mar Rostopopoulos says top three movies of all time. It's a very difficult question, but I'm gonna go with Meet Me in St. Louis, which this is the Blu-ray book, which is different than the tape that I showed off before. So Meet Me in St. Louis. And Repo: The Genetic Opera, and then American Psycho. So, I would say those are my three favorites. Like bridging like different genres and stuff. Very, very good. Ever tempted to upgrade a DVD I owned to Blu-ray? I'm very tempted, and I often do it. But like I have standards, so I'm not gonna just blindly, if I have. Here's one for example: Repo: The Genetic Opera. One of my favorite movies of all time. Still haven't gotten the Blu-ray because I'm like, is the picture gonna be that much better that I need to like get to? I really like the slip on this. This has amazing bonus features on it. I'm sure the Blu-ray has them too, but it's like, I already own this and the DVD is fine. Now, if the picture quality on the DVD sucked, then I would upgrade it. And I think the Blu-ray is only like $8 or something last I checked, but it's like, I really don't. I do double down on things, but it's like only if, now if it had cool artwork and it was $8, then yes, but the artwork is standard. So, if it's like artwork that I feel like I need, or new bonus features, or a big improvement on the picture, then I'll double down. But I'm not gonna do it for no reason. I'm not like, oh, I have to get every version of this movie. Unless it's Fight Club, obviously. Any interest in animation movies, or have I seen any Studio Ghibli? I'm gonna show a couple. First of all, I like anime. I always have liked anime. I haven't watched a lot of it in recent years, but so here is a movie that I like: Aqua Teen Hunger Force: colon movie film for the theaters for DVD. So I love Aqua Teens. They're one of my favorite cartoons of all time, one of my favorite shows of all time. So there's that movie. Here's another piece of animation that I love, Free Birds, which is a Thanksgiving movie. Owen Wilson and Woody Harrelson play the two main turkeys. It has a strong vegetarian agenda to it. So, be warned of that, but I absolutely love this movie. I think that it is so cute. And it's just like a feel-good family movie. And then I've seen a lot of Studio Ghibli movies. I don't own a lot of them because, they've always had like a high price point. So, I bought my sister like the full, I don't remember, years and years ago. There was like, I think it was like maybe even bootleg, but it was like some complete Studio Ghibli set. Which came out like before Ponyo and what was the other one? Like the Secret, like the Arrietty or whatever came out. So years before that, there was like this weird DVD set, and there was like The Cat Returns and like My Neighbor Totoro and my favorites though I do own. I own Spirited Away. But I absolutely love this story. I think that it's beautiful. I mean, it's like demented and weird, but I think that it's amazing. The no face monster is creepy, so there's that. Absolutely love it. And then Howl's Moving Castle, I think, is beautiful also. So, those are definitely my two favorites from that. How many Criterions or Arrows do I have? I didn't count because they're all like, I don't have them in their own section. They're all intermingled with the rest of my movies, but, I definitely only have a handful of Criterions, maybe like 10-ish. Arrows, I'd probably say like, I don't know, maybe upwards to like 30 or more. I need to finish inventorying my stuff on Blu-ray.com and then do like a collection video with like stats and stuff. So that's a good question though. Which do I prefer, Kino, Criterion, or Arrow? And I love them all for their own reasons. I think that Kino puts out a really great selection, and I love that their spines are all like uniform and sleek looking, really attractive. Criterions, I think the Criterions are like the ultimate like collector version of a movie, but they don't put out like a super ton of movies that I'm like into. Like a lot of their stuff is different genres that I'm not really like trying to watch. But then Arrow, so of the three, I'd probably say Arrow is my favorite because they have the movies that I'm looking to see. They have like a really nice collector version of it, and they have all the special features and stuff. So Arrow is definitely my favorite. Any movies that made me angry, nauseous, cry with laughter. I have an example for each of these. So angry, a movie that made me angry. I don't own it. I watched it digitally during Gyllenhaal January last year, and that was Love and Other Drugs. And why it made me angry was because of like its implications about the pharmaceutical industry. So basically, like Jake Gyllenhaal and Anne Hathaway play this couple, and he's a pharmaceutical sales rep, I think, for Viagra, and she has like epilepsy, and I think she has epilepsy, or maybe Parkinson's. I think she has Parkinson's disease, and she keeps getting like worse. And it's like while, they're it's like this love story about their relationship, but the whole time I'm just sitting there like, oh my God, pharmaceuticals are evil. I couldn't enjoy the movie because of that fact. A movie that made me nauseous is the movie Murders, which I absolutely love. This is a fantastic movie, but it takes a lot of willpower to watch it, knowing what you're in for. So there's a part where somebody gets flayed, and I can't, like, it was just too realistic. I can't, it takes a lot for me to watch that. A movie that made me cry with laughter. I love comedies, but a lot of them aren't like laugh out loud funny to me, but this one was What We Do in the Shadows. And there was also and I watched this because it's from the creator of Flight of the Conchords, Jermaine Clement. And this is like the Taika Waititi or whatever his name is, isn't it? But I love Jermaine, so I'll support anything that he does. And this was absolutely phenomenal. And I also like the series of this. Haven't finished the series. I need to get back to that actually. But the series is phenomenal. even though it doesn't have Jermaine, but it's still good. But What We Do in the Shadows is laugh out loud funny. Have I ever acted or been in a play? Not really. Like when I was in college, like I was first like an English slash like theater dual major. So in some of my theater classes, I had to like, and I never like acted in a production, but I had to act in some of the theater majors, like senior projects and stuff. So even though it wasn't like a school production, it would be like, you know, a major like final for them, or like their you know, their final project for their degree. So I did a lot of acting. I studied a lot of acting in my theater classes, but I have no interest in it. Next questions come from my husband, Louis Switcher. The first question is, what are my top five Christmas films? This is difficult. I didn't even dive into the realm of like Christmas horror because I feel like if I'm gonna watch a Christmas movie, I wanna watch a feel-good Christmas movie. So these are my go-tos. My number one go-to, my favorite of all time, is Christmas Vacation. You know, it's legendary. So you know, movie lovers or just like regular normies, I think that we can all quote this movie. It's great. This one I almost didn't put in because I was like torn between this and the Santa Claus, but I don't own the Santa. Actually, I think my Santa Claus tape is put away somewhere. So, picked Ernest Saves Christmas. It's amazing. The next one's The Muppets Christmas Carol, which Louis Switcher got me. This one usually makes me cry. I think that it's amazing. This is my favorite rendition of a Christmas Carol. So, Michael Caine is amazing in it. He plays Scrooge, and we have like the music in it is phenomenal. Like it's, you know, I really appreciate the Muppets and Jim Henson. So, and Sesame Street, you know. And then we have Bad Santa. I absolutely love Bad Santa. It's a every year you have to watch it. Oh my gosh, can I just say that Bernie Mac and John Ritter absolutely make this movie. Like that's pretty like laugh out loud funny too. Fucks large women, what can I say? Like I love it. And then not this one. Arthur just sent me this, but Elf, the actual Elf, is one of my top five favorites. I watch it multiple times every year, and I own it digitally because I usually watch it on my phone or something while I'm working. But I absolutely love it. James Caan's in it, Mary Steenburgen, my husband's crush, Zooey Deschanel, many people's crush. You have to hear her sing, so you have to deal with that. What's my favorite Kino Lorber release? I didn't even look. Not looking at like features and stuff, I'm gonna say Mr. Majestic was my favorite so far because it's really badass. Any chance we get more guest appearances? Movie and Toy Collector 13, Physical Media Man, Joe Martinez, in 2022. I think that's my husband's way of asking, are we gonna go on vacation again? Because Movie and Toy Collector 13 lives near us. We see him all the time. Not really, you should come over more, Rob. But then Physical Media Man lives about 5 hours from us. Joe Martinez lives farther, like 12 maybe. Like, I don't know, a long way. So, yeah, I think my husband's trying to ask if we're gonna go on vacation. So, yeah, I would love to. You guys are welcome on the Extreme Featurette channel anytime. What does the future hold for TGIX? I don't know. I mean, I guess I'm gonna keep recording videos until I'm like, why am I doing this? And then I'll stop. But for now, I'll keep doing it. Probably gonna focus more on reviews. I don't know. If you guys have any weird suggestions for stuff that I do. And last time I asked that, everyone's like, do out and abouts, do out and abouts. Well, I work from home and I don't go out and about because there's people out there and I try to stay home. So, you know, like people want to see a collection video or a movie room tour, and maybe that will be, you know, in the cards for 2022. So who knows? How did I get so fortunate to grow old with such a hot babe? Well, YouTube, I guess. Yeah. Yeah, thanks for that. And thanks, Charles Band. Matt Simpson asks, top 10 slasher movies. This was difficult. What are you guys trying to do to me? Okay. So, And now that I'm looking at my list, I don't even think I got 10 here. I got like 8. So let's see. First off, Intruder. This is a full moon flick, but Bruce Campbell's in it. This was amazing. I could watch that forever. Pieces. And I did not include like Gialli in this. So, like, if you want to, I was like, if we're gonna be including Gialli in this, then that would be like way too difficult. So I was just like, Pieces is definitely not a Giallo. So, one of my top slashers, The Texas Chainsaw Massacre, Behind the Mask, which is just a really fun, like, kind of a spoof on slashers, but I love Leslie Vernon. And The Burning, which is classic. Jason Alexander, hottie. My husband loves that. And You're Next, which is a fantastic, like, new slasher. Very, very good. Then why don't we just throw in Friday the 13th Part 6, Friday the 13th Part 4, and I didn't pull it, it's over on yonder shelf, but I'm gonna go ahead and say Laid to Rest, Chrome Skull. And then I forgot to pull this one also, but why don't we just throw in Army of Darkness, because I only counted 8 before, so there we go. Marie from the Martinez Joe 74 channel asks, what are my favorite videos to make? I would say reviews. Whenever it's a movie that I actually really, really like and I'm super interested in what I'm talking about, that's my favorite. And what's my favorite company? She said Thinking Kino or Arrow, and yeah, I'd say Arrow. And she also said, great to meet you guys. And it was likewise great to meet you guys. Transitioning on into Joe Martino's questions, he says, what got me into collecting? That was really like, I kind of like moved out of my mom's house in like 2007, 2008. And my mom had like satellite dish, and I was way too cheap and like, just didn't want to bother with any of that stuff. So I just started buying like used DVDs at CD Warehouse. And it was kind of like a cord cutter type thing. So I was like, why would I spend that much money on cable or satellite whenever I can spend that much in a month and have like, five or six really, really good movies or TV shows that I can watch as many times as I want, whenever I want. So, that was really the beginning of me collecting. It was mostly all at CD Warehouse, back in the day. So, really fond memories of that. He also said, what made me start doing YouTube? That was like years and years ago. Like, my ex and I bought this Full Moon Mystery Box, and, I don't even know why. I literally to this day don't even know why I recorded us opening it, but I recorded opening it. He's like, you're not gonna put this online, are you? And I'm like, I don't know. So I did. I recorded it and put it online, and I don't know why. I really don't. Like, we didn't watch a bunch of Full Moon like unboxings before buying it. And I wasn't really into watching unboxing videos, but I really like getting like mystery boxes and unboxing them. So, it's just how it started. It was really a lot of unboxings in the beginning, and it wasn't until like I started, I don't even know, like along the way, I was just like, well, I'm just gonna talk about these movies because like I watched something and I'm like, oh my God, this is so good, I gotta talk about this one specifically. So that was kind of how reviewing came to be. And then Joe says, who was my favorite person I met in 2021? I'm gonna go ahead and say Gary, the Gare Man. So it was good meeting all of you, but yeah, he's definitely the one that sticks out in my mind. So yeah, that was super fun. If you have not seen that, Joe Martinez, Marie, Physical Media Man, Rob, Movie Toy Collector 13, we like all got together in like April, late April, I think. So they came over to me and Louis Switcher's house, and we hung out. And if you check out Physical Media Man's channel or Joe Martinez's channel or Louis Switcher's channel, you'll see highlights from that. So it's pretty cool. That was very, very fun. And AOJT says approximately how many titles are in my collection? I really have no idea, but I think each one of these shelves holds like 75 DVDs ish. So, and I have like some of them like displayed out like this to try to like distribute some weight. So, just counting the ones that are like really full, and then the Blu-ray ones hold more, but I'll just say whatever, 75 each. That's 14 different shelves like this, so that's gonna be over 1,000, like just on these two shelves. So that's gonna be like 1,000 just like behind me. And then over there we have like Kino and Full Moon, and that's probably like another 100 or so, maybe more. And there's horror and Christmas movies over there, which is definitely like over 200. And then there's like TV shows and stuff over here, and then there's tapes, and then there's doubles and stuff we have upstairs. So like all together, I'd probably say we're like pushing 2,000 titles. I don't know. That's my guess. I am trying to scan this all in the Blu-ray.com app so I can know what I own. That's the end goal. But what sucks is like I have another shelf upstairs that I'm trying to build. It's like a small little media shelf, but you know, we kind of try to keep it all in the movie room, but it's like, you know, how much space do we really have? So, you know, that's why we try to be like selective and not, you know, if we watch something and don't love it, we'll trade it in or sell it or whatever. So, just trying to keep the best of the best so we can have titles like, you know, The Brady Bunch in the White House. The best of the best. That's what I'm talking about. So a big thanks to all of you again for asking these questions and subscribing and making this all possible. It was super fun for me. I hope that you guys enjoyed it. And you know, let me know if you liked this because we can do it again in the future. Definitely won't do it too often because I took a bunch of stuff off the shelves and I hate doing that. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. I will be reviewing something next week, so come back next Friday and see what that is. Probably the movie The Victim from Kino because I just watched it. I hope you guys have a great weekend. Thanks for checking this out, and I will see you next time.